Welcome back, students. In our previous video, we have seen how to start your program with 64-bit assembly language. Now in this video, we will focus on the use of macros, why we need to use the macros, and if you want to use it, then how to write it, the syntax, and how to call it. So this is our program which we have seen in last video as well. Let's consider, I want to display one more statement. One more statement I want to display as a part of my output. So what we need to do, yes, again in dot data section we need to define the variable along with the content, the message value, and then using the line of this instructions we need to again display it. So first we will define it in dot data section. Why in dot data? Because the content, the value we know before the execution. So let's say I've given the variable name as msg2. Again, my type will be same, define bytes, and in double quote I will specify the message. So for example, I want to display good day as a message. Then in similar way, again we'll calculate the length. So this will calculate how many total characters are there between the two double quotes, and then assign it to the msg2 length variable. Now in dot text section we need to display that after the first message. So what we will do, after this system call I need to repeat all these instructions with respect to message 2. So let's first we'll copy the instructions, and where we need to change, yes, here my variable name is changed, and along with that my length variable name is also changed. So what it will do, so this first 5 lines will help us in displaying the very first statement, that is hello, and then this next further 5 lines will help us in displaying second message, and last one we will execute the execution of, we'll terminate the execution of your program with this rx,60 system call. Now we'll check the output, how it results in the output. Yes, see, first message is displayed and immediately that second message is there. So now if I want this second message on the new line, then is there any provision in assembly level language? Yes. So what you need to do, just identify or just decide where you want the new line, and there appropriately use 10 or 0h, it is equivalent. So suppose I want new line or enter bit after the first message get printed, so here I can write it as 10. So we'll see the effect. See, first message is displayed and then second message is displayed after the new line. So this is how, as per your requirement, you can add the respective 10 or this 0ah, it is also having the same effect. Now where macro plays important role, let's consider like this two, I have to display 10 different messages in my program. So what I need to do, I need to write this line of instructions for 10 times with change in variable name and its length name. And remaining, if you observe clearly, the system call will be same, the register used for that respective operations like RDI, RSI, RDX, for storing the length, for storing the address of the message, everything will be same, only these two variables are going to change. And because of that, we need to iterate or we need to repeat the code for that many several times. So macro helps us in reducing this repetition. So what macro is, when we have some repetition kind of thing to be included in our program, then we can write the macro for it, so that when we call the macro with the relevant input, then that specific code will be executed. So what is the use of these macros? It helps us in reducing the line of code. Very primary use of macro is the line of code will be reduced. But execution wise, yes, of course, it is making some burden on the time complexity. Okay, so first we'll start with how to write the macros. So before writing macros, macros should be part of which section? Yes, it should not be part of any of the section. It should be outside all the three sections. So as per the convenience, what we will do, just before text section, we'll try to define the macros. Okay. So we'll start defining the macro. The syntax is like percentage macro. This is common for all the macros. Space and then followed by name of the macro. Like this, we use for writing or displaying. So I can give the name for this macro as print. So this print is nothing but name of that macro. After that, how many total number of inputs it is taking as a input, that we need to pass. So here 1 and 2, two different variables are required. So my total number of inputs are 2. Okay. So this is the first statement to start the definition of the macro. Then what you want to do, then that statement should be part of the definition. So this we need to repeat. So what I will do, I will just copy this and paste it here. Okay. So system call for write, then file handle, it will be same. And then to end the definition, this is the syntax. So what this will do, when I call this macro, then the message and this message len, whatever we have calculated here, it will help in displaying this message only. Now we want to make our program unonymous, means it should work for any other variable which is declared in data. So what provision we have, it's like we can pass the inputs by reference like this. So what this percentage 1 and percentage 2 refers to, you must have remember in high level programming language, you are passing the variables with ampersand and the name of the variable. So in the same way, here the syntactical difference is there. So you are just passing it by reference. So here percentage is the symbol used to pass your input. So this is your first variable you need to pass. This is second variable name you need to pass. Then how you will call it? So we'll just see the effect, how we are going to call it. Yeah, so for calling the macro, name of the macro should be same, whatever name, because this macro name is case sensitive. Okay. So this macro name followed by how many arguments it is taking. Here we have defined or declared that two arguments it will require. Suppose I want to display this message, so I will pass, this is my first argument and this is my second argument, right? So this will help us in displaying of the first statement. Now in similar way, I can display the second message as well. So I just need to pass the appropriate variables separated by comma. Now we'll just check whether it is working or not. Yes. So what happens because of macro, whatever the line of code, it is being reduced. So initially we were writing 5 plus 5, 10 total lines, and now it is being reduced to the 2. So what we need to do, only we need to define macro, and that definition will be only once, and calling will be as per our requirement. So if there we need to just pass the appropriate variable. In a similar way, we can write the macro for exit as well. So just we'll try to write the macro for exit. So this is percentage macro. Exit is something, why I'm giving the name exit, because you are terminating the execution. So here you can use any name. Now it is not taking any input variable, if you observe. Okay. Only 60 is the system call and you are passing return code as 0. So no any arguments means 0 should be there. Then whatever you need to pass this macro definition, and then you can end it with end macro. And here if you want to call it, so just call the, because it is not taking any kind of argument. So we'll just see whether it is working. Yes, you're getting the same output. So this is how your macro is useful in reducing the line of code. But yes, execution wise, how actually macro executes, when we call this macro, let's say it is at number line number 27. So the complete definition, this macro definition, get replaced at this line, and then it will take these two inputs and then it will show its output. Okay. So macro expand itself where it is called, and that's why it is taking some time in execution. But as lengthwise, number of line wise, you can reduce the number of line definitely using the macro.